Now we will find out the values of these trigonometric ratios for some specific angles. We will discuss 45 degrees, 60 degrees and 30 degrees first, and later we will see for 0 and 90 degrees. For 45 degrees, we will consider an isosceles right angle triangle. What does it mean? One angle 90 degrees, and isosceles means two sides are equal. So we have assumed the sides as A units. So in this figure, if one angle is 90 degrees and these two sides are equal, by the property of isosceles triangle, the angles opposite to equal sides will also be equal. It means these two angles will be equal. And if these two angles are equal, suppose they are of x degrees each, it means 90 plus x will be 2x. Is equal to 180 degrees by the angle sum property of the triangle. So 2x will be equal to, this 90 will go this side. So 180 minus 90. So x will be equal to 90 by 2. That is 45 degrees. It means this is a triangle whose two acute angles are equal and 45 degrees each. Now in this we will find out the values of all six ratios. So, first of all, we will find the hypotenuse in terms of A, because we do require the hypotenuse for sine theta and cosec theta also. So, in triangle ABC, by Pythagoras theorem, AC square is AB square plus BC square, and AB and BC both are equal and both are equal to A units according to our assumption. So this will be 2a square. So the value of AC will be under root of 2a square, that is under root of 2a. Clear? Now this hypotenuse is under root 2a. After this we will find out the value of sine 45. So either you take angle A or angle C, both are of 45 degrees, that can give you the value. So sine of 45 degrees. Suppose I am taking this C. For this C, the side opposite is this AB. So that is AB upon hypotenuse is AC. And in terms of A, what we have taken, this is AAB. And AC is root A. A and A will be cancelled. So, sine 45 is 1 upon root 2. Similarly, we will find out cos 45. Cos of 45 degrees. Same angle I am considering. So, for this cos 45 degrees, the adjacent side is BC, that is the base. So, BC upon hypotenuse, that is AC, and BC is A, and AC is root A, so that is 1 upon root 2. It means for 45 degrees, sine and cos are same. The third is tan of 45 degrees. For the same angle, the side opposite, that is perpendicular, is AB, and the base is side adjacent to that angle C, that is BC, and both are A. So both will be cancelled. So tan of 45 is 1. On the basis of these three, other three we will calculate directly. What are the other three? Cosec 45 and sec 45 and cot 45. So cosec 45 degrees will be just reciprocal of this, because cosec is reciprocal of sine. So AC by AB. So it will be root 2 by 1. It means only root 2. Similarly, sec. Sec is reciprocal of cos. So that also will be root 2. And cot, which is the reciprocal of tan, that is 1. So first three we will calculate. Other three we will write the reciprocals. So these are the values for sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec and cot for 45 degrees. with the help of isosceles right angle triangle. Now we will discuss about 60 degrees and 30 degrees. For that we will take an equilateral triangle ABC. We know that all three angles of equilateral triangle are equal and each angle will be of 60 degrees. For that, now we have done one construction. Construction is AD is perpendicular on this BC, and we know that when we draw a perpendicular from a vertex in an equilateral triangle, it is also a perpendicular bisector. So that will bisect this side BC. We have taken all three sides of this equilateral triangle as 2A units each. And since this AD is perpendicular bisector, so BD and DC both will be A units each. Now we will find out the angle 30 degrees and 60 degrees. This is already 60 degrees, that is same angle over here. And I said for an equilateral triangle, this is the perpendicular bisector as well as it is the angle bisector also. So this line will be perpendicular bisector as well as angle bisector. It means that it will bisect this angle. Which angle? Angle A. So this angle ADB, this will be of 30 degrees. Okay. Similarly, this angle will also be of 30 degrees. Now we will consider one triangle, that is ABD. For that, first we will do for 60 degrees, then we will come to 30 degrees. So now we are considering triangle ABD. Okay, now in triangle ABD, angle B is equal to 60 degrees. Now, in this triangle, AD is not known to us for which we wanted for sine theta, because sine theta means sine of this 60 degrees. This is 60 degrees, and for this 60 degrees, we require the side opposite to that, and that side opposite is AD. So, first we will calculate this AD in terms of A. So, in this triangle ABD, angle B is 60 degrees, but as I said, first we will apply the Pythagoras theorem, and for that AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square. What is our need? AD. So, AD square is equal to AB square minus BD square. AB is taken as 2A. And this BD is A by the property of perpendicular bisector what we have taken. So this will be 2A the whole square minus A square. So that is 4A square minus A square. So the value of AD square is 3A square. It means that AD is under root of 3A square. That is under root of 3a. It means the value of AD is under root 3. Now we know this AB in terms of A, we know BD is in terms of A, and we have calculated AD in terms of A. Actually, this is the altitude of an equilateral triangle. Directly also one can write, but if you want to calculate, you can take the help of Pythagoras theorem. Now let's see the ratios. First we will see sine of 60 degrees. In this triangle ABD, sine 60 will be side opposite, that is perpendicular, upon hypotenuse. And perpendicular is how much? First we can write in terms of the sides, AD upon AB. AB is the hypotenuse, because perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that will be root 3a, and AB is 2a. So this is root 3 upon 2. So sine of 60 degrees is root 3 upon 2. Similarly, we will find out for cos. In the same triangle ABD, we will consider angle B, that is 60 degrees. So cos of 60 degrees, for this 60, The base is BD. We are only taking this triangle ABD. Okay. So BD upon hypotenuse is AB. And how much is BD in terms of A? Only A. And AB is 2A. So cos of 60 degrees is 1 upon 2. Similarly, 10 of 60 degrees. 10 of 60 degrees will be perpendicular upon base. It means AD upon BD. So AD is how much we have calculated? Root 3A. And BD is A. So 10 of 60 degrees is root 3. What have we seen? Sin 60 root 3 by 2. Cos 60 is 1 upon 2. And tan 60 is root 3. The reciprocals. The reciprocal of sin is cosec. So cosec 60 will be 2 by root. Sec 60 will be 2. 2 upon 1 is 2. And cot 60 will be 1 upon root 3. So what have I said? Cosec 60, sec 60 and cot 60 directly can be found with the help of these. So 2 by root 3, 2 and 1 upon root 3 are these three ratios for 60 degrees. Now we will see for 30 degrees. The same triangle we will consider, but this another acute angle is of 30 degrees. So in triangle ABD, we had already calculated this AD in terms of A that I have written already, root 3A. Now for this 30 degrees, the side opposite is BD. So when you write for sine 30, okay, sine 30 will be BD upon AB. So BD upon AB, and BD is A, AB is 2A, so this is 1 upon 2. Similarly, we will calculate for cos 30. For this 30 degrees, this is the base side adjacent to that. Okay, so that is AD upon hypotenuse. Same, that is AB. So AD is root 3A and AB is 2A. So cos of 30 degrees is root 3 by 2. Then we will calculate for 10. We will find the value 10 of 30 degrees. For this 30, the side opposite is BD. So that is BD means perpendicular upon base. And the base is AD. So BD is A. And AD is root 3A. So this is 1 upon root 3. So what we have observed? Sin 30 is 1 by 2. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. And tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. Directly we can write the other three ratios which are reciprocals. So cosec 30 will be 2. Sec of 30 will be 2 by root 3. And cot of 30 degrees will be root 3. So these are the ratios for 30 degrees. Now we will discuss about 0 degrees. It means that in this right angle triangle ABC, which is right angled at B, this angle A, we will try to shift this AC in such a way that this angle A gets smaller and ultimately it will become almost 0. When this angle will become 0, these are the cases what I have drawn, that ultimately this line AC, can you see it is coming down, and the last stage this AC will merge in this AB, and we can say that this AC is almost equal to AB. But in this process, what happened to this BC? BC tends to 0 because BC is merged. It means that point C and point B are almost same. they cannot be exactly same. Why? Because AC is the hypotenuse. And a hypotenuse cannot be equal to one of the sides in a right angle triangle. But we are saying almost, okay, approximately equal. So we will see about this angle A, which is becoming 0 degrees. So for that, what we have observed, angle A is 0, AC will be almost equal to AB and BC becomes 0. So now look at this triangle ABC. Sine of 0. Remember, we are talking about angle A. Okay, for this it will be BC upon AC. Perpendicular means side opposite to this angle A. That is how much? BC and upon AC. AC is the hypotenuse. Now what have we seen? BC is become 0. Why? Because this point C is come closer and closer to this B, means almost it is coinciding with this point B, which is actually, if you see practically, it is not possible, because as I said, this AC is the hypotenuse, but we are taking it is almost equal to this. BC will be 0 and AC and AB are equal. Now BC is 0 and AC, so 0 upon any quantity will be 0. So sine of 0 degree is 0. Now cos of 0, for this angle A which has become 0 degrees, cos is based upon hypotenuse. Now for this angle A, what is the base? That is the side adjacent to this angle A, that is AB and AC. AB upon AC, what have we observed? AC and AB are almost equal. So we can say that it is 1, because AB and AC are equal, it means you can say if AB and AC are equal, the ratio of these two will be 1. The last is 10. For this angle A, which has become 0 degrees, then this is perpendicular, that is BC, and this is AB. So BC upon AB. Now what is BC? 0. It has become 0. So 0 upon anything, that will be 0. So what have we observed? Sine of 0 is 0. Cos of 0 is 1. And tan of 0 is 0. On the basis of this, we can write the reciprocals of these three ratios also. Now, be careful. When we are writing cosec, this is AC upon 0. Why? Because cosec is hypotenuse upon perpendicular. So, AC upon 0, when we are writing, anything upon 0 is not defined. So, cosec 0 is either you say infinity or not defined. Then opposite or reciprocal of cos is sec. So sec of 0 degrees. This is 1. Its reciprocal will also be 1. Then cot of 0 degrees. This is AB upon 0. Cot will be B upon P, base upon perpendicular. And if we write it in this form, that will be not defined. So you have to be careful for these two. Directly don't say this is 0, so its reciprocal will be 0. No, this is 0 means it is 0 upon some number, and some number upon 0 will be not defined. So these all are for 0 degrees. Now we will discuss about 90 degrees. It means that this angle A, we are bringing this point A closer to this point B, means the new position is here, and ultimately this point A will merge with this point B. It means that angle A tends to 90 degrees. When this angle A becomes 90 degrees, just imagine that this line is no more, this line is no more. It means that this line AC, which is the hypotenuse, it is merged with this BC, or this point C, that is also become 0 degrees. For this, we will calculate, or we will see the ratios, all 6 for 90 degrees. So first we will see sine of 90 degrees. Sine of 90, always remember we are considering angle A. So for angle A, the side opposite will be BC and hypotenuse will be AC. So that is BC upon AC. Now look at this. BC and AC are almost equal. It means this is 1. So sine of 90 degrees is 1. Now we will see for cos. Cos 90 degrees. For this angle A, the side adjacent, that is the base, that is equal to AB upon hypotenuse is AC. Now look at this AB. This point A is merged, means it's come closer to this. It means AB is 0. Okay, so that is 0 upon AC, this will be 0. So cos 90 degrees is 0. Now 10. 10 90 degrees for this angle A, the side opposite is BC, perpendicular, and the base is AB. So BC upon AB and AB is 0. So you can say BC upon 0, which is not defined. Reciprocal of this. Cosec will be 1, but sec of 90 will be AC upon 0. So not defined. And cot of 90 degrees will be 0 upon BC. So that is 0. So we can write as cosec 90 will be 1 and sec 90 is AC upon 0. Anything upon 0 is not defined. And cot 90, that is 0 upon BC. So 0 upon BC is 0. So these are 6 ratios for 90 degrees.